Hi, I'm Tracy Christensen, your host on Community Connection. Salt Lake City is a hub for creative learning and artistic innovation. Craft Lake City is one organization that holds workshop series designed to appeal to creative types of all ages. I'm joined now by Angela Brown, who's here to tell us about their upcoming events. Welcome, Angela.
Thank you so much for having me today.
Yes, you guys do some fun things.
We do.
Tell us about the DIY Festival.
Sure. So DIY, it stands for Do It Yourself. And this is actually the event that was the catalyst for the 501c3 nonprofit Craft Lake City is today. So 6 years ago, I had this really great idea of doing this fun, handmade, large-scale arts and crafts festival and in the heart of Salt Lake City, in downtown Salt Lake City. And so we named it Craft Lake City after our city and invited all of the Utah artisans to come out and show and display their handmade goods. And it just went off so well that now we have become a year-round organization with lots of programming.
Did you ever think that your idea would grow like that?
You know, I guess yes and no. I hoped that it would, but sometimes you just kind of have to try and see what happens and see if the community is open to the idea. And thankfully, the Utah community did like what they saw and wanted to participate, and we've just grown year after year.
So now you say you do things year round. Tell us about some of those year round events and then the festival.
Sure. So part of our mission is to educate and inspire the creative culture of our state through science, technology, and art. And so part of that have been with some new partnerships that we've established. One of them is with West Elm City Creek. And so we go into their store, beautiful setting, once a month and offer a home decor based craft workshop. And we pick out one of our Craft Lake City DIY Fest alum, so someone who has participated in the festival in past years, and invite them to come teach a craft for the community. And it's a really affordable fee. It's only $10, and that includes all of your materials. And
wow.
The store gives us 2 hours to sit in this gorgeous environment and create.
Be inspired by all of the pretty things.
Exactly.
That's a cool idea.
Yeah, it's really fun. And we've also, that's been so successful that we started another partnership this year with the Natural History Museum of Utah. And that's been really fantastic because it really focuses on bridging the gap between art and science. Mm. And so, for instance, one of our recent workshops that we did was we taught the public how to build terrariums. And again, we're in this beautiful environment of the museum where they've got exhibits about botany and things that are very applicable to what we're creating that night. And so again, we reached out to one of our Craft Lake City DIY Fest alum who's participated in that festival in the past and asked her if she would come in and instruct a team of 30 how to build their own terrariums.
What a creative idea. I love
Thank
it.
You.
Those partnerships are great. So people on your website, I imagine, can find out about those different workshop series.
You've got it through craftlakecity.com. We also post about them through all of our social media accounts. We're on Pinterest, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter.
Great. Yeah. Now, the festival itself, tell us about what we can expect when we see there, or if people want to participate, how do they apply?
Sure. So, unfortunately, applications have closed for right now, but you can go ahead and mark it in your calendar for next year.
Right.
They open in March and run through through the beginning of May. And then we announce late May who will be part of the next year's DIY Festival. So, we've got actually, besides the artisans, you know, there's over 200 artisans that, again, are showing off their handmade goods, anything from cross-stitching to handmade skateboards to we actually have a guy in our science and technology building that this year is showing his handmade synthesizers, which is really neat.
Yeah.
So, and that's kind of an area that we've expanded over the past 3 years. This is our third year with our science and technology building, and we have a category in there for our DIY engineers. And so these are the guys that make robots that are tinkering in their garage, building 3D printers, and just, it's a really great category to show off the ingenuity and entrepreneurship that I think our state is really known for.
That really opened up a whole new area, didn't it?
It really did. And, you know, because it's not just about selling things. It's also about sharing ideas and empowering the public to go home and think, okay, what can I create? What can I make? What can I do myself?
So exciting. Thank you, Angela, for being here.
Yes.
And for increasing our creativity in Utah. At 11, our goal is to keep our viewers apprised of events going on all throughout the state of Utah. To learn more about what's going on at Craft Lake City, please visit kbyu11.org and click on Community Connection. Thanks for watching. Please join us again on Community Connection.